In other news, more than 200 people are now feared dead following the sinking of a boat carrying asylum seekers off Indonesia. The tragedy has prompted a government appeal for all sides of politics to work together.
Hope for a new life turned into despair after the death of so many.
There was very heavy waves inside the water, so our boat is sank.
250 or 260, and all of them is dead.
Their boat bound for Australian waters sank off Java on Saturday. It's believed the asylum seekers were from countries including Afghanistan and Iran. We have been helped by fishermen and local people in this operation. Australia is also helping. A Navy patrol boat and two surveillance planes assisting local authorities in rescue efforts. Australian Federal Police based in Jakarta have also been dispatched to help investigate the disaster.
There have been 33 people rescued.
The tragedy has highlighted the political stalemate since the Malaysian deal was rejected by the High Court. For the first time, Cardinal George Pell has called for the reinstatement of offshore processing, but both the Labor Party and the Coalition aren't budging because neither side wants to lose face.
The reason that there isn't offshore processing today is because this government dismantled it and they've only had half-baked proposals to bring it back.
Nauru didn't deter people smugglers and that the best way to put in place strong disincentives was the government's Malaysia agreement.
But there is some hope of a bipartisan solution.
The government supports offshore processing. The opposition supports offshore processing. We need to work together to get this done.
Matt Moran, 10 News.